Good old days of Doctor Who, when Daleks ruled the universe, or at least tried to. Well, since then, there have been almost as many actors playing the part of Doctor Who as there have been monsters for him to conquer. But one of the most famous actors to take the role was Jon Pertwee, who's currently appearing at the Empire Theatre in Liverpool. Today, he came face to face with Carl Hawkins, who we sometimes think is from another planet.
It's a long time since you were Doctor Who on screen, but you attend Doctor Who conferences all over the States.
That's right. Yes, I haven't been. I went into Doctor Who about 1972, I think, and I was in it for 5 years. And then I came back on the 20th anniversary for the five Doctors, in which there were five of us in it. And I've since been, as you say, to countless conventions in the United States and in Canada.
And then, of course, from Doctor Who, the wonderful Wurzel Gummidge for the last... What? How long is that now?
Wurzel Gummidge has been running for 10 years now, over a period of 10 years. Yes.
Is it so long? To start with, made in Hampshire, then recently in New Zealand.
In New Zealand, yes. Wurzel Gummidge down under, yes. In Zuniland, that were.
Did you enjoy that?
Yes, very much. Yeah. Mm. I loved it. New Zealand's a beautiful country, and it's very much my scene. I like all the country, and I like the calmness of it, and I like the food. Food is wonderful. I mean, you cook it yourself. The restaurants aren't that brilliant, but, I mean, you get superb fish and vegetables and fruit and for very little.
Apart from the theatre, I mean, the radio that you started with, and we all know the voices, and you were in the longest-running radio show ever.
Yeah, the Navy Lark. Yeah, 20 years.
20 years of that. Mm. That must have been fun, too, actually.
That was wonderful, yeah. Well, we only did it because it was fun. We didn't do it because of the money that was in it, because there wasn't that amount of money in it. There never was in radio. But we did it because it became a part of our life. Every Sunday for 26 weeks of the year, we'd all meet. And Ronnie Barker was with us then, and Dennis Price originally, and Leslie Phillips, and Michael Bates. And we had such a wonderful time. We laughed ourselves through all the rehearsals uproariously. And the producer, Alistair Scott Johnson, showed extraordinary patience, because anybody else would have absolutely thrown their hands up in horror and abandoned us, because we did not behave well at all. But we went on year after year after year because of that, because it was such fun to do.
Now tell me something about this show, Doctor Who's Ultimate Adventure.
I must say that it's not just a show for kids. When we were at Wimbledon, we did capacity business, enormous business, and then we went to Aberdeen last week, and the word got around that this was a kiddies show. So matinees were absolutely jammed-packed, but the evening shows were very disappointing. So I want to say that it's a show for family viewers, family viewing.
Well, it's jolly nice that you've stopped through Liverpool. We're absolutely delighted to see you.